This video will show you how to calculate the hot crack susceptibility, also known as the hot tearing tendency, during solidification for an aluminum-silicon alloy. Hot tearing is one of the most common and serious defects encountered during the casting of aluminum alloys. The information gathered from this type of calculation can help you choose the right alloy composition to reduce the occurrence of hot cracking. This calculation uses the crack susceptibility coefficient property model, which was introduced in Thermo-Calc 2021A. The calculation is based on the example PMG07 hot crack susceptibility, which is included in all Thermo-Calc installations, beginning with Thermo-Calc 2021A. If you want to run the calculation file included in the software, it is accessible from the Help menu, Examples Files, Property Models, General. The example uses a demo database, so it can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc 2021A or newer, including those who are using the free educational package. I will now walk you step by step through setting up the calculation. To begin the calculation, click on the Property Model Calculation Template from the home screen of Thermo-Calc. All the nodes we need to run the calculation will appear in the Project pane. Select the AL Demo Database and the elements Aluminum and Silicon. We are now done defining our system, so select the Property Model Calculator node from the Project pane. Select the Crack Susceptibility Coefficient model from the list of general models. Make sure that the composition unit is set to mass percent. We do not need to set the condition definitions because they are not relevant to this calculation. Under Configuration, we will accept the default values the program gives us. We will discuss these in more detail later in this video. Next, select the one-axis calculation type. Set the grid definitions to mass percent silicon with a minimum of 0.01 and a maximum of 5, with 10 steps. Now select the Plot Renderer node from the Project pane. Under Crack Susceptibility Coefficient, uncheck the automatic scaling box and set the limits from 0.22 to 1, stepping at 0.1. Our plot is now set, so click Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is finished running, your plot will appear in the Results pane. The plot shows the crack susceptibility coefficient, also known as the hot tearing tendency during solidification, as a function of mass percent silicon. The crack susceptibility coefficient tells us how likely an alloy is to crack during solidification. High values mean that the alloy is more likely to crack, and low values mean that the alloy is less likely to crack. As you can see, at the beginning, when the silicon content is low, the alloy is not as susceptible to hot cracking. But as the amount of silicon increases, susceptibility increases rapidly. At about 0.5 mass percent silicon, the crack susceptibility reaches its peak of about 0.9. It then rapidly declines and reaches a low point between about 2.6 and 3.6 mass percent silicon. According to these results, your alloy should contain either small amounts of silicon or more than 2.6% silicon in order to keep the crack susceptibility coefficient low. If you are running the example file, you will also see the experimental data, which is in excellent agreement with the calculated result, considering the uncertainties and difficulties in hot tearing measurements. I will now discuss the model that this calculation is based on. You can read a basic description of the model in the Property Model Calculator under the Description tab, or a more detailed description in the online help by searching for Crack Susceptibility Model. The Crack Susceptibility Coefficient, or CSC for short, describes the effects of alloy composition on hot tearing. However, even though we are looking at the composition of the alloy during the calculation, the model for CSC is actually based on time. The model is based on the idea that there are critical times during solidification when the alloy is most vulnerable to cracking. If you can reduce these times, you reduce the likelihood of cracking. The model uses the general Scheil solidification simulation and assumption of a thermal condition where the default is that the heat flow is proportional to 1 divided by the square root of time. Since Scheil solidification simulations do not take time into account, thermal mode allows us to introduce time into the model. The crack susceptibility coefficient is defined as the time during solidification where the casting is vulnerable to cracking, or TV, divided by the time available for the stress relief process, or TR. Let us consider the highest point of crack susceptibility on the plot, which is at about 0.5 mass percent silicon and has a crack susceptibility coefficient of about 0.9. We can look at a simulation we created to demonstrate the model at this composition. The plot shows the fraction of liquid as a function of time. The crack susceptibility model in Thermo-Calc is based on a paper by Klein and Davies that concluded that when an alloy has a liquid volume fraction between about 0.6 and 0.1, it is sufficiently fluid to avoid cracking. Therefore, this is known as the relaxed zone and is defined in the equation as time relaxed, or TR. Additionally, at fractions of liquid below about 0.01%, the material is too strong to crack. Therefore, the range when the material is considered to be vulnerable to cracking is between about 0.01 and 0.1 fraction liquid. The time spent by the alloy in this vulnerable range is defined as time vulnerable, or TV. These limits can be configured in the model setup, but we have chosen to use the defaults for this example. We can see in this plot that the time spent in the vulnerable zone is almost as long as the time spent in the relaxed zone. This makes the equation approximately 4.5 divided by 5, equaling 0.9. which is the crack susceptibility coefficient we see in the results. If we now look at a similar plot, but for mass percent silicon of about 3, where the crack susceptibility coefficient is near its lowest point, we can see that the time spent in the vulnerable range, TV, is much shorter relative to the time spent in the relaxed range, TR. This gives us the approximate equation of 2 divided by 8.3. resulting in a much lower crack susceptibility coefficient of only 0.24, which is what we see when we look at the results. To learn more about this model, visit the online help by selecting Help, Online Help. Search for Hot Crack Susceptibility and select About the Crack Susceptibility Coefficient Property Model. We hope you enjoyed this video. To watch more videos about Thermo-Calc, visit the video tutorials page on our website.